rather walk it with the number 6 block. But I use the block. I hold the block at this angle first to squeeze the glass off the boil. If I can, I just take the block off before I stop turning. It's way safer that way, because if you stop pushing the block up, it will burn for a second and pick up a bunch of ash. So as much as you can, only touch the block while the glass is turning. Now you'll see if you can go back and forth. If you find some wet, old block, well burned in, it's not going to matter. So there's my initial block. I'm going to let the sides that are relatively thin cool down a little, stiffen up, and I'll blow again. Very, very often seen nations do this twice. Blow very softly, and any Venetian can gather at this point. I like to wait a little bit more. Now, this next gather is a coating gather, so let some glass slip off. Be aware, the level is high now, so to let some slip off, you're going to have to hold it above the glass and then do that. So have the door open only as much as you have to, otherwise you let it in and it closed while you're letting the glass in. The eggs are just a little bit gathered as much. So I just turn 1, 2, and then I lift it up and rotate for 1. Number 6, but the number 8 is there if you need it. It depends on how burned out the number 6 is. It's a little tight. You don't want to squeeze it in. So use the 8, and it doesn't matter if you're not filling it. Now this is an optic setup, so you want the bubble to go to the tip. Yesterday we were doing standard setups, two gather standard setups. This is an optic setup. Somewhat of linked spheroid for the globe. The bubble into it. That's so that the tip will get bent. Now, number one thing to do at this point is to make this. Is to make it tapered and about the right diameter for the globe. And only experience will tell. We can put out ones we're not using, have an idea. Somebody grab the open optic bulb there and just plop it on top of here. It's
open.
I'm monitoring it to a chamber. That's sort of one of these. Now be aware that the canes stick up above the bulb about that high, and I'm going to use them. So I pull on the tail, holding it upside down, make the tail point, straighten it out a little bit. So that's about right. Now put your blow hose on. Kind of like the octagonal form in the new something called. Here we go. Now, y'all have somebody open the door for you. I'm going to do it solo. So, you open the door. Be careful not to jerk it around. Be gentle. And then, very carefully, touch bottom and blow. Release carefully. There you go. And try not to slam that door. Because when you bump that thing around, the canes will fall. Now I want to get rid of my blow hose. My next thing to do is to make sure the gauges are stuck on. So after a big flash, touch them, and if these are soft, push them off the boil. If they're not, bring these. After you've done the gauges, definitely adhere to the bubble, definitely, because they will, if they're not stuck on, they will get in trouble. There you go. After that, my next thing is to turn this into a cylinder. Remember how I said a couple of days ago when we start off the bubbling that you need to take the ball and pull and do all that stuff with the bubble in the shape of a cylinder. That's why we spin come out of the octagon, and that's why we hold it down on our way to the bench before we make the ball and all that stuff. So what I'm doing right now is making the ball. So I've already done from the upper end down. I'll reduce it a little further down to the distance to make sure the things aren't getting jagged on the ends. Now my next goal is to close the end. Now the end is actually open. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to jack down so that all the paints come together in one point. Do it as close to the end as you can. Because anything you put away is wasted. And I've been doing these things, saving them since the winter of 1980. You can take this, get it like that, and just throw it in my spot if you need it, please. I've been saving those since 1983. Without a camera on, and 10 years ago I would have told my standard oil joke at this point, but what the political correctness and the very concerned about that. I don't do that anymore. Now, I'm armor the tip. Repeat armor the tip. You can armor the tip in place some, and every once in a while, armor the sides, make sure it's nice and straight. What we're doing now, think of this as making a standard setup. Armoring the tip, repeating armoring the tip. The tip isn't thick, but we need to armor it really cool for this next step to work. And the next step is going to be, we're setting it up like a standard setup. But what we're going to do, I'm going to treat it like I've just come out of the octagon. I'm going to make ball, pull, twist, blow, yank, blow. And then it's just like an octagon. So we'll work that out. Thank you. Kind of a combination of non-optic and optic. Non-optic is that when I go to the bench, I'm going to marble the tip while I'm there over here. Marble the tip. Now, it's like optic. I'm going to make a ball, pull, twist, blow, yank a little, come up, and sub-second like that. Start turning the tail, turning the neck, it's a little stubby, so for the moment I'm going to treat it like a neck sphere. I'm going to heat it and elongate it a little bit. Let's take our first piece of vase, something on the tall side, finish your neck, neck and shoulder, finish. Now we're going to heat the bubble and elongate. Note that I'm heating shallow enough so that I don't zap the that comes over to a lot of feet. Go in there. reflective of the infrared. Use the heat treatment so that when you blow, everything will blow out. Use the flying Sovietta.